Revising the loan estimate is where we're going to go next. And I can tell you from a review standpoint, this is where our review team spends the most of their time because all of these revised disclosures need to come with a story. And most of the time, the story checks out, but sometimes the story is missing some elements and we've got to imagine some things, and that's where things go wrong. And so page number 73, let's talk about it. If the lender has information and that information affects the tolerance baseline, causing it to be out of tolerance, hey, that tolerance can be reset if the information has been received, if the information that we've received is utilized within 3 days. I'll talk more about the 3 days in a moment. But when they use this information, hey, what I mean by use this, it's information that causes us to be out of tolerance, that if we issue a new disclosure, it resets the tolerance baseline based on that information. So if we're going to reset tolerances, a new disclosure has to go out the door within 3 days of learning of the information that caused the tolerance baseline to be out of tolerance. These are mostly discretionary. In other words, most of the time we could ignore them. Hey, in a couple pages, I'm going to show you the one time it's required. I bring this up because if you're reviewing a loan file and you see information that looks like a changed circumstance and it was ignored, that's okay. They don't get to reset the tolerance, and it might cause them to be out of tolerance, but it's okay because it's mostly discretionary. Could that cost the bank? Yes. Let me give you an example, though, of why I stress it's discretionary. Let's say that we have new information. Okay, that new information is going to cause a 0% tolerance item to increase by $10. So let's just say we estimated a $100 fee, and now with this new information that's a changed circumstance, it's going to cause the fee to increase by $10. Now, if we do nothing, we absolutely know that we will have to eat the $10 increase. Now, everybody, when this rule came out, went, oh gosh, we don't want to have to give any money back to the borrower. I want you to think about it differently. Okay? If we do nothing, it's going to cost us $10. If we want to save the $10, we've got to issue a new disclosure. The question is, what's it going to cost you to chase down the $10? What's it going to cost you to put together a new disclosure and make it meet what we haven't talked about yet in letter B or in letter C, okay, and chase down that $10? If it's going to cost us internally, okay, let's just say $200 to chase down 10, we'd have been better off eating the 10 because the net, if we go chase it down, is that it cost us $190. Yeah, we saved 10, but we spent 190 more. Well, that's not good business, is it? Now, I know $10 here, $10 here, it all adds up, right? But the point is, maybe there's a reason we are going to ignore that change circumstance because we're not going to spend $200 to chase after $10. That's not good business. So something to think about from a lender standpoint, no doubt, but from an auditing standpoint, if you start to see they're not doing change circumstance redisclosures all the time, maybe it wasn't worth our efforts to do so.